Thank you. lot going on the bridge deck as of right now. Looking pretty good on the Marauder Trail and Community as of right now. Looking good here. The viaducts are also looking just fine. Turn down here is still just an eastbound network over Red Road. It's still clear for this time of night, but the First Avenue is pretty busy. We're going to the highway to the main route, so it is slow here to the floor. The towards you with the line. We're going all the way straight. Nothing going on. All the 99 is out there. 152nd off ramp from Highway 1 or through the Port Van Bridge from both of them. Awesome. No delays, not a lot happening as you work your way up and down the bridge deck.
on Highway 1 through regular Vancouver, all the way through Burnaby, Logie, and the Barnett, also great. And with that, we move on to the Neal Street Bridge exit. They're fantastic, very fantastic. Not a lot happening on Nitre Oak Street. The bridges themselves are wide open, and there is not a lot going on as you work your way northbound, southbound over on the Arthur Lang. As we get ourselves down to the George Massey Tunnel, George Massey's doing great. Not a lot happening as you work your way through the 99 north-south through Richmond as of right now. And looking even better on 99 northbound-southbound all the way through Delta. Now, the Alice Fraser Bridge is also great, but before I do a full report on this one, if you're unaware, it's road work going on Scott Road in between 75A and 72nd Avenue. Left lane blocked off in both directions. It's been going on for quite some time. It's an overnight project, and you see some delays through the area. And, I mean, there's some road work delays. 128th is looking pretty open. All right, so now a full report on the Alice Fraser Bridge. You're wide open on the 91 northbound, southbound, east-west connector is for sure. East-west connecting. All the other on-ramps are cooperating. Over to the Queensboro 91 in Marine Way, Stewart's Way. It's all A-okay. As of right now, I like what I see all through New West and Burnaby for the time being. And we move on. Over to the Patello Bridge, King George Boulevard and McBride Boulevard also doing just fine. Not a lot going on as you work your way through the area. King George all the way down into South Surrey, still like what I see. Highway 1 all the way down into Abbotsford, still looking great, and we move on to the Fifth River Bridge. Highway 7 is looking great, no delays on the side of Loki and Highway as of right now. Moving over to the Golden Ears Bridge, northbound, southbound, not a problem to be found. And we can wrap this one up with the Mission Bridge, Highway 11, both sides of it, A-okay as of right now. Anything out there less than A-okay, let me know what's up, where it is, and what it is. Do it safely, though. The phone number here is now 730.
Chances are, you're not thinking about your garage door right now. But what if Creative Door Services can boost your curb appeal and increase the value of your home? Lift your enthusiasm yet? Creative Door offers Western Canada's largest selection of garage doors for every kind of budget, plus expert repair, installation, and maintenance services to keep your garage door operating its best. We've got you fully covered. Find your perfect garage door at your Creative Door Services location or at creativedoor.com and master the remarkable today.
With more time spent inside, Thompson Industries is here to make sure you're comfortable. For over 25 years, they've helped Lower Mainland residents stay warm and keep cool with the best in heating and air conditioning. Thompson Industries takes great care to exceed every safety measure, offering industry-leading warranties on a huge variety of options for any space. On top of Fortis BC and Hydro rebates, Thompson Industries is offering no monthly payments and no interest for one full year. Request your free estimate at thompsonindustries.ca. Job done right, day or night.
Canada Marine and Shipbuilders Local 506 offers top wages, benefits, and a great pension for its members. And right now, they're hiring red seal trade persons from a variety of different backgrounds. Apply online now, Marine and Shipbuilders Local 506.ca.
AM 730 traffic.
Driven by BCAA. In case of engine trouble and more, BCAA is only a click or call away. Join today at BCAA.com.
News on John Street. BC's latest COVID-19 numbers are in. The province recorded 45 cases in the past 24 hours with no new deaths. 60 people are in hospital with the virus, down 3. Of those, 12 are in the ICU. No change there. Almost 80% of eligible British Columbians have one dose of COVID vaccine. 3 men have been charged with human trafficking, and now Vancouver police are looking for more victims or witnesses. Emily Lazatin reports the case involves underage girls.
Vancouver police were tipped off in 2019. Investigators believe underage girls were recruited and trafficked for several months. Constable Tanya Vizentin says 3 men have been charged. Elkan Vizigaro, Miaz Nor Elvin, and a young offender who cannot be named.
Also believe that the recruiting was very general. It happened online, it happened in person.
There are many unanswered questions. The exact ages of the victims, and are they from the Lower Mainland or overseas?
This does happen all over Vancouver, all over the province, all over the country. It is quite alarming. It is the harsh truth.
Anyone with information is asked to contact Vancouver Police. Emily Lazatin, Global News.
Updated stats from the Macy Coroner Service show just over 800 deaths recorded during our recent heat wave. Global's Janet Brown reports.
The Coroner Service says there were a total of 808 deaths in BC during the so-called heat dome.
from June 25th to July 1st. During the same period last year, deaths numbered 232. 353 of the deaths over the span this year were in the Fraser Health region, 202 in Vancouver Coastal Health, 98 on the island, Interior 122, and Northern Health 33. All deaths reported are being investigated for the cause. Jana Brown, Global News.
From the Global Newsroom, I'm John Strait.
The Chinese government is accused of aggressively targeting Western democracy with disinformation and hostage diplomacy. From Global News, I'm Jeff Semple, and on my new podcast, China Rising, we'll separate fact from fiction and hear from accused spies, whistleblowers, and others caught in the political crossfire as the pandemic rages across the world and incidents of anti-Asian racism rise. Listen to China Rising for free on Apple Podcasts, Spotify, or wherever you get your favorite podcasts.
When your truck and trailer need repair, who has the time to go to a service repair shop? We have alignment shop and body shop to get it fixed right. Not you. You are going to ATI Truck Repair. It's an ICPC heavy-duty collision shop. They do it all, from truck and trailer repairs to computerized wheel alignments to damping and roll-up door repairs. Save downtime and contact them today. Your one-stop fleet maintenance shop, accredited by the Better Business Bureau. ATI Truck Repair.
The Chinese government is accused of aggressively targeting Western democracy with disinformation and hostage diplomacy. From Global News, I'm Jeff Semple, and on my new podcast, China Rising, we'll separate fact from fiction and hear from accused spies, whistleblowers, and others caught in the political crossfire as the pandemic rages across the world and incidents of anti-Asian racism rise. Listen to China Rising for free on Apple Podcasts, Spotify, or wherever you get your favorite podcasts.
Ourselves down to the George Mass Massey Tunnel. George Massey's doing great. Not a lot happening as you work your way through the 99 north south through Richmond as of right now. And looking even better on 99 northbound southbound all the way through Delta. Now, the Alex Fraser Bridge is also great, but before I do a full report on this one, if you're unaware, it's road work going on Scott Road in between 35A and 72nd Avenue. Left lane blocked off in both directions. It's been going on for quite some time. It's an overnight project, and you see some delays through the area. And, I mean, the thing about this one, too, is you can't actually use 124th to get around this one, it doesn't look like, because of a separate project going on 124th between 68th Avenue and 69A, which is just enough to, you know, take 124th out of it. Use 128th to get around the road work on 120th. Doesn't seem like it is worth a detour, but just in case somebody's in a hurry, they don't want to drive through some road work delays, 128th is looking pretty open. All right, so now a full report on the Alice Fraser Bridge. Wide open on the 91 northbound, southbound, east-west connector is for sure. East-west connecting, all the other on and off ramps are cooperating. Nor is the Queens Road 91 in Marine Way, there is way. It's all A-OK. As of right now, I like what I see all through New West and Burnaby for the time being. And we move on. Over to the Patello Bridge, King George Boulevard, and McBride Boulevard also doing just fine. Not a lot going on as you work your way through the area. King George all the way down into South Surrey, still like what I see. Next up is going to be the Portman Bridge. Now the Portman itself is doing just fine. No major delays on Highway 1 all the way through Coquitlam. Highway 1 all the way through Surrey, through Langley, down into Abbotsford also just fine. Surrey should have this new issue though, a lift vehicle that happened over at 152nd at Guilford Drive. I was told the truck was blocked off in all directions. If you have more on that one, #730, please, and thank you. Highway 1 all the way down into Abbotsford still looking great, and we move on to the Big River Bridge. Highway 7 is looking great, no delays on that side of Loki and Highway as of right now. Moving over to the Golden Ears Bridge, northbound, southbound, not a problem to be found. And we can wrap this one up with the Mission Bridge, Highway 11, both sides of it, A-OK as of right now. Anything out there less than A-OK, let me know what's up, where it is, and what it is. Do it safely, though. The phone over here is #730.
Yeah.
152 at Gilbert, but one thing's for sure, I don't think southbound's blocked anymore. I'm going to need an update on this at pound 730 if you're around in the area. And if anybody's wondering, yeah, the first thing I did was try to find a camera in the area, and there isn't one. So I can use a bit of help on that one. Pound 730, what's going on with the flip vehicle? 152 at Gilbert Drive, westbound delays persist. That's it, though. You can get away from it by using 105. 105 Avenue runs in between 150th and 148. So that would be, between 150th and 150.
Sidewalks are